Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The hypocrisy of Christians who attack the prophethood of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Christians have attacked the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by falsely alleging that he is a murderer, rapist, and pedophile. They charge him with all these disgusting crimes, yet they have all been soundly refuted. However, only for the sake of argument, let's now assume that their lies against the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are true. Does that disprove his prophethood? Many of the arguments that they present are emotional, thus they commit the fallacy of appeal to emotion. They argue about things that they don't like regarding the Islamic legal system and claim that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instituted immoral laws. They reject that in Islamic lands, the government may cut the hand of the guilty thief, or execute the apostate, or even permit a man to marry more than one wife. They reject these laws because they don't agree with or understand them, even though these laws could be found in their own Bible. It's like me rejecting Christianity because I simply don't like the idea of someone dying for my sins. Christians would then argue that I'm committing the fallacy of appeal to emotion. However, why do they then commit this fallacy against Islam and not allow it when it is used against them? The prophets of the Old Testament have committed countless atrocities, from genocide to the killing of infants, yet the Christians acknowledge them as prophets of God. But when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is seen in history as doing something that Christians deem as unacceptable, then according to them, this means that he is not a prophet. Do you see the hypocrisy? Christians may reply back by saying that they acknowledge that these biblical prophets were sinners, while most Muslims view their prophet as sinless. Well, if prophets could be sinners according to Christians, then why do they refuse to consider the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a prophet because in their mind he was a sinner? By them agreeing from the beginning that a biblical character can be a prophet and a sinner, then all they have done is shown that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can also be considered a prophet as well, even though they claim that he committed sin. Their reasoning does not disprove his prophethood, since according to them, a prophet could be a sinner. You may hear Christians argue back that Islam justifies the major sins that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam allegedly committed, whilst the Bible condemns them. However, nowhere in the Old or New Testament do we see any condemnation for the atrocities committed by the biblical characters. The criteria that Christians use to attempt to disprove and attack the prophethood of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam can be used even more forcefully against the prophets of the Old Testament. So even if a Christian were able to prove these arguments against Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are still nowhere as bad as the acts done by the biblical prophets in the Old Testament. If they insist that sin disproves the prophethood of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then they also need to insist that the prophets of the Old Testament were not prophets as well. Therefore, they should renounce their faith in Christianity, for Christianity requires that you believe in the Old Testament prophets and that the book as a whole is inspired by God and given authority by Jesus in the New Testament. In conclusion, many Christians are hypocrites for rejecting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam based on a reason like sin, even though they accept the biblical prophets who have committed far worse sins on a far bigger scale. Don't forget to subscribe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.